Once again, Japan springs into action to make all of your augmented reality dreams come true.
When the mainstream press and the government says nobody could have predicted this, they're lying through their fucking teeth.
It's November 22nd, 2014. I'm Dana Durnford, also known as Nuclear Proctologist and proud of it, .org. And you can find my live streams at Beautiful Girl by Dana and at many other sites. I usually start off these live streams. These are just for entertainment. I'm back ashore for the last 2 weeks. I'm heading out in the next couple of days, as I can't leave before everything is ready, though. So,
November 22nd, 2014. I'm
David Durk. And so, it's streaming good. What point did I want to make? No, you know, the weather is not that great this time of year, but I'm not worried about that because I have a highball operation. It's just that the boat, it's just so many things take so long, and I got to learn to give it up and just move on, because I don't need to do the things I'm doing to go. Just, I can't stop doing the things I'm doing at this stage. I want to fix everything perfect so I never got to touch another thing forever. Just turn the key every day and go to work. Hi, Paul. Hi, Starlight. And it usually takes me 5 minutes to warm up. Candace, Toxic, Biddle, Tube. He said he's seen somebody's comments said ads were removed. Well, people could remove their own comments. You could remove the comments you got there, and it'll say that. Only one watching. That'd be you, Biddle. Elmwood, Ping, Toxic, Shanikin, Missing Sky. And Shanikin's Elaine, folks. And I know I keep saying that lately, but because Elaine is such a good soul, I want to make sure everybody knows who she is. Shanikin775. And Missing Sky doesn't stop. Miss Milky the Clown 1 doesn't stop. And Crashlight, Britta Youngy, I had trolls were using your account to attack me. Over and over and over. Nonsense. I'm not saying you were doing it, but they were using your name and your picture to attack me. Hi, WizKitten! Hi, honey. How are you? Bob. Ginger Don. Cotton Top. That's Mickey, folks, because Mickey's got a new account. And who else did I miss? Starlight. Slacky Lady. Yeah, one watching. Google doesn't work that good, pretty. Right? See all the comments going up there? That's not me. That's somebody else. A whole bunch of somebody else's. There's got to be more than one person here. I'm just having fun. Cats Alive. Lunar. We're almost ready to start the stream. Miss Milky has gone into hibernation mode. She's been at this for 3.5 years. Got herself worn out. And I can imagine, because I know how much time and energy and effort it takes to do the things she does, how frustrating it gets. Hi, Annie Beck. You made it. And I'm just watching the comments. A bit lazy tonight. I'm a bit lazy tonight. You smoke a cigarette? You don't like it? Go somewhere else. Or complain about it and I'll block you. And you won't have to worry about coming back and seeing me do it again. And by the way, you know, your automobile produces more carcinogens than my cigarettes can. And your car can do it in 1 hour than every cigarette I've ever smoked in my friggin' lifetime. Couldn't produce what you're producing. And 16 container ships produce more pollution than all the automobiles on the planet. One container ship with those 5,000 containers on it produces more pollution than all the automobiles in Canada, all the automobiles in New Zealand, all the automobiles in Australia combined. One ship. There's 90,000 of those ships on the ocean. That's the animosity equivalent of 42 trillion people. 4 trillion with a T. Yeah. And so frig off with the cigarette nonsense. I don't tell you how to live your life. Don't tell me how to live my life. I got addicted to it because there's 4,000 chemicals in it. They never told me about that. They pushed it on me when I was young. The doctors and the teachers says, you got a headache, have a cigarette. You don't want to go to school, have a cigarette. Had a fight with your girlfriend, have a fucking cigarette. And, you know, 4,000 chemicals in a cigarette. How the fuck am I going to give that up? How are you going to walk away from that? Cigarettes with no chemicals in it. You try finding that. Took forever. And then it's just nicotine. And there's 40 years of studies. I know I'm ranting now. Another meltdown. What do you mean another meltdown, slacky lady? Where? Hi, Shanigan. Thank you. Yeah, it took me forever. Iron my coat, my shirt tonight. It's one of those shirts you really got to work. The big ships have two cycle engines. Well, they burn bunker fuel. I'll jump into Fukushima. Give me a second. But the big ships, they burn bunker fuel. Bunker fuel is the stuff that's left over after the production of petroleum products. And this stuff is supposed to go into a toxic waste site at $1,800 a ton. Instead, our idiots that we elect, our morons, our dipsticks, dipshits, have decided that these big ships can burn it, and they're only burning about 15% of it. The rest are releasing to the atmosphere. It's shocking. Everybody demonize you because you're smoking a cigarette. Shut the fuck up. Yeah, look up 16 ships produce more pollution than all the cars on the planet. I got links for it, but I can't find shit off the top of my head. I can go find the headline for you, though. Never mind, don't get me started. What's the headline? 16 ships. I'll tell you the headline to go look up. But it's not just that one headline, but that'll get you started. They link over to a whole lot of stuff. So, look at the aerosols from the dust and pneumonia that comes over. I actually done videos on my site, 16 ships produces more pollution than all the cars on the planet. And there's links under that. How 16 ships create as much pollution as all the cars in the world. And once you go down that rabbit hole and you start researching this and you start finding all the links, you start looking at all the research and you start looking at the researchers and you start looking at their studies and you look at the people that they worked with and looked at their studies and their research, then you realize what I'm saying is 100% true. And back to Fukushima. I only got one cigarette, so leave me alone. Because I don't want to get up and go get the rest of them. I'm just kidding you. It's been a rough day. I haven't stopped. It's been just an unbelievable rough day. I'm ninnying at this stage trying to get everything perfect. Because I'm just waiting. I'm probably not going to pull out of here till Tuesday or Wednesday. And it seems like I just got home after 60 days on the road, on the ocean, and I'm heading back out there again. And I'm not complaining or nothing, I'm just saying it feels like I just got home because I haven't stopped since I've been home. And I'm not saying that's here or there, who cares, whatever. I just happen to be talking, folks. That's Unit 1. I got to do this again every fucking night. This is Unit 2. This is Unit 3 and 4. And they all got something in common. They all have done something we've never seen before. These are all 100% meltdown, melt-throughs, and melt-out, and aerosols and atomizations of their inventories. All of them. Number one, just because he doesn't look like Unit 3 and 4 don't mean that number one is not bad, because it is. It's horrible. It's unimaginable. It's many, many, many times, just that one alone, many, 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 many times worse than Chernobyl. That's not counting what's in the fuel pool. Fuel pool. I got a fuel pool! I got a fuel pool! Fuel pool! And Unit 2, same thing. Meltdown, 100%. We've never seen that on the planet. That one there is many, 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 many times worse than Chernobyl. Chernobyl, over 1 million dead. Chernobyl, over 3 million children with disabilities. Chernobyl, still contaminated. 28 years later, Chernobyl still can't get in there. This is unit 3. This is original pictures. And I show you these pictures over and over and over and over. These particular pictures over and over and over and over. Because they want to show you the sanitized ones where it's all cleaned up. Where they got in with the cranes and picked up all the junk around it. And the bulldozers came in and shifted it somewhere else and buried it. And people walk by it and get x-rays and neutrons all the time. They don't want you to understand the actual accident and stuff. They don't want you to see the actual buildings, what they really looked like. They don't want you to be able to put two and two together yourself and look at it and say, hey, you know what? Those buildings are destroyed. Yeah, TEPCO put a nice shiny, I'll go find it for you. TEPCO put a nice shiny. Wow, I tried to bring in some music. Night didn't work for me. I got to change the format. Where's Shithead Toe? Hang on, there he is. So they put these sanitized sightings around the building. But look at the building. They never went in there and cleaned it all up. Look at it. See all that? Right. What they done was they put that sanitation around it. They brought it in with cranes. This is the homeless. And the destitute and the victims of society, they're sent in there to get their x-rays and neutrons. And most of these people won't live more than 2 or 3 weeks. And they'll be kicked loose and they'll die on the streets homeless and destitute and ripped off and murdered. And they're standing on titanium and lead plates. And so the crane picks it up and drops it in there. That was the original base. After that, you're not going to see anybody stood up on that stuff. And so they built a structure up, and then they built a structure across. And the idea is, in the future, they're going to put a crane in. This is Unit 4. And here's the homeless. Smile. Or you're not getting your $15 bonus. And we'll lock you up in the shed on the site again tonight with the x-rays and the neutrons and the broken rods. See who's laughing in the morning, if you're still alive. Well, actually, you'll be dead if they've done that to you. Put a rod in the room with you. These are all the homeless victims. These are all dead. They died quite a while back, I'm sure. So they built a structure up and across it. You see, they put a little cap on the edges. They never went in the building. And so, you see how nice that looks? Well, they claim on the inside of it looks like that. Now, why would they build that structure outside of it? Why would they build that structure if the crane is perfect? If the walls are perfect? If the building is perfect? Why? Does that look like it detonated? And see, that picture there is why the trolls come after me and complain that I used this picture. Well, this picture is Unit 3 and that's Unit 4. That's what it looked like. By trying to get people to only look at the sanitized building and use that stuff only, this stuff is hid behind it. That's all you know, they're not fixing it. They can't get in there. They can't get in Chernobyl. Not yelling at you, yelling with you. Let's go back to that. I was having fun that time. I'm too close to the TV tonight. What else we got here? So inside the building, there's this wonderful building, this crane. But we got to build a crane outside of it to get the rods out of the pool. We're going to pluck them out. It's really dangerous. Right? Wait, now they're all inside of it working on the building. How come they don't go down to Chernobyl and clean it up for us? Huh? Maybe we should send all the homeless here in Canada over there. And they can learn how to do it and they come back here in case we have an accident in Canada and then they can fix it. Meanwhile, let's build a fable. We're going to build a structure up and across the top of it. Because it's so nice inside. Because it's gorgeous. I can't tell the difference. Look at the walls. They'll ask me, it's just too friggin' stupid. Anybody falls for that is pretty gullible. Look at it. That's inside of that. Yeah? No, I'm not lying. They're all TEPCO's pictures. Right. Inside of that building is a beautiful building. Oh my goodness, it's gorgeous. Look at that. Look at the ceiling. Look at the walls. Inside of this building, number four. Sometimes I can't see myself in the screen, so sometimes I'll point that way, but when I can see, I can catch myself what I'm doing, but that's unit four. There's unit four. That's what it looked like. Now, I'm just curious of how they ended up with this wonderful building inside of it. They can't do it at Chernobyl for some reason. Chernobyl's only one third the size. Chernobyl's only a 30% meltdown. Chernobyl's only graphite. Chernobyl, they had 600,000 educated conscripted soldiers. 600,000. Then they had 400,000 tradespeople. It was only one third the size. How come they can't go down to Chernobyl and do that? Right. Yeah. Look at it. You don't think that's a lie? You don't think they're lying to you? You think they're really in that building? Do you think they're really in Unit 4? Huh? I can't hear you. Are you gullible? Because if you think anybody, if that building, you think those buildings over there are in that building behind me, because that's what it looked like when it blew up. How can you end up with that in it? You can't. It's a maniacal lie. Look at the roof. Look at the walls. Look how shiny it is. Remember, these explosions were felt 25 miles away. They were felt 25 miles away. Do you think the building itself is going to have a couple of okay places? No. No. Right. And then all the models of the dispersals are for that they're telling you about. All that dispersal is based up on a couple of days from this building only. It didn't include this building, and it didn't include that building, Unit 3, which is 2 million times worse than any other reactor on the planet, and it doesn't include Unit 4 in that model. So that model is based up on a couple of days of just iodine and cesium, not the 2,000 other elements, man-made ionized radiated elements, and every one of them will give you cancer. Every one of them. No matter how small of the particle you ingest. And originally when Fukushima was breaking, they were all coming out muddling the water by telling people, oh, you can wash it off. Nobody's worried about washing it off. And by the way, you couldn't wash it off with battery acid if you wanted to. You just liberate the element again. You have a big hole in you. You'll be a lot of pain. But this model is only based upon two elements. It's not based upon all the reactors on the ongoing constant continuous releases. So this model and every other model that you show is only based upon a couple of days releases from a single reactor. And it doesn't include the other reactors. It doesn't include the spent fuel pool. It only includes what they say they vented. But these buildings melted down in a couple of days, long before they tried to build the model. And so they knew that. Harvard told you. Stanford told you. MIT told you. I showed you those videos. March the 14th, March the 15th, March the 16th, 2011. That there are a couple of melt through, melt out. Boom, boom, boom. Stuffy. Yeah. Seriously. I know, kid, yo. No, no, no. You gotta hang Abe. Set things right. Just hang them. Fuck it. You're allowed to hang people in Japan. No one will notice if you hang Abe anyway. I think they should, right? Or put him in the firing squad. Put that up on YouTube so we can enjoy it. That'd be pretty cool. And he deserves to be hung. He's a fucking twisted, demented moron. He wants to open all the nuclear power plants. He wants people to eat radiated food. He wants people to move back in and get fucking murdered with cancer, kill their children, so he can have a paycheck and he can get a whole bunch of big payoffs when he gets out of office. Fuck him. Hang him in the fucking street. He's a fucking murderer. He's murdering people every day. Fuck him. And fuck you if you don't agree with me. Because he deserves to be hung. Urethol, peroxide, hydrogen, sulfur, bucky balls. These morons in Japan, of course they had no option. They shouldn't have had it. They shouldn't have built the reactors anywhere in Japan because there's one big fucking earthquake fault line. If you don't like me swearing, fuck off. Go away. Fly the fuck. Urethol, peroxide, enhanced nuclear fuel, corrosion in seawater. Well, this is where the sulfur creates these spherical buckyballs, and they're able to ingest radioactive elements and particles. And those radioactive elements and particles turns those sulfur buckyballs into a little nuclear engine. That is unbelievable, unimaginable evil. And that are 1/10,000th of a millionth of a meter. That are smaller than the dust that floats around in your house that you cannot clean up. You ever see the sun shining through your window and the dust? Fucking 1,000 times smaller than that. If you ingest a single particle, and you did, you will get cancer in 5, 10, 15 years at best. But these were all hot particles. These are hot particles. And I haven't stopped. I haven't stopped, man, in 3-4 months. I haven't stopped in over a year. I've been blogging this shit for over a year. And we're getting headway. But let me go back and remind you. Let me give me a hard time here. Hang on. I just want to throw out a couple of these things sometimes. Let me swap them. Come on. There you go. Dr. Raymond Gilmedi. Modeling a carcinogenic risk in dogs that inhaled 238 plutonium. 1998. Combined the analysis of 260 lifespan beagle dogs that inhale plutonium. For instance, of lung, bones, and liver tumors with models of function of cumulative radiation dose. You're getting a cumulative radiation doses every day. Lung tumors, la 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 la, la 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 la. And what happened? They all died. Bone tumors, leukemias, liver tumors, brain tumors, heart tumors. And he done studies. This twisted, demented Dr. Raymond Gilmedi from Loveless, New Mexico, Respiratory Research Institute. They killed beagle and dogs and puppies over and over all day, every day for 35 plus years. You can go look it all up yourself. Go look up and you'll find out that this shit kills you. It's not like potatoes. It's not like bananas. I'm having a hard time not seeing anything. I'm too close. I was trying to get rid of any fuzz in the background. Any way I can do it is sit up close to the freaking camera. Whatever. And so potassium 40, this is what the models, they show you to trick you. They'll say, oh, there's radiation in your food, Dana. There's radiation in bananas, for goodness sakes, Dana. There's radiation in your meat and your potatoes and your booze and your water. But that's potassium 40. That's homeostasis. And what that means is your body will regulate it. It means that if I drink 7,500 becquerels of potassium 40 in a glass of water, and I do, my body is made to drink that. My body, everything on this planet is acclimated. Potassium 40, it's in my clothing, it's in everything that's made. And you can't add any more to a volume because it's what they call homeostasis. It's an equilibrium. Your body regulates it. Like a thermostat regulates the temperature in your house, and but much finer, and like your car regulates, your cruise control regulates your speed. It's homeostasis. It's harmless. It's stupid. Yet they put it out there all the time. And a Geiger counter is not going to read a banana. The potassium 40, A guy, you gotta take a cubic meter of water, dry it all up, and then weigh it up by the grams, and there's like 25 becquerels per gram, divide it up, and per glass of water, you come out with your number, and that's how we have 7,500 becquerels, is we took a cubic meter of water, dried it up, took the potassium 40, because you can't fucking find it with a Geiger counter. Anybody tells you that needs a shot in the head, and then one in the mouth just for good luck. Location of spent nuclear fuel and high-level radioactive waste, because they don't know what to fucking do with it. Because they're idiots. They're the stupidest fucking people imaginable. They're literally monsters. In every shape and every form of the word. And every country is like it. Because no one will stand up and fucking go off on them. Get back in their fucking faces. Well, that's what I'm doing. That's what I'll always do. But look at it. Look what they're all doing the same thing to you. They got nowhere to put the waste. Will you people wake up? Will you people wake the fuck up in the media? You lying sacks of shit. Look, here's what Russia might do to America. I'm yelling, I know. Don't like it, fuck off somewhere. Here's what America done to themselves so Russia wouldn't do it to them. I'm yelling because I'm sick of saying the same thing every night, because every day I got to listen to Ken Buesler's from Woodhouse Olson, the Graphic Institution, lie to everybody. And watch the media never fact check them one time. Not once. I smash every one of you fuckers I ever give me hands on you. I hate you. I despise you for what you're doing to us. You can't have a debate with anybody because everybody thinks it's like a fucking banana. Because you fuckers lie and lie and won't fact check these cocksuckers. Right, you do that to yourself. And that's just 51 to 61. Not the 70s. Not the fucking 80s. Just 51 to 61. And this is what Russia might do to you. So you gotta turn around and fuck everything in the country. Every piece of land in the country. Because the Rushkies might fuck up a little bit of your country. And you'll kill the planet before you give it up. You're over in other people's countries firing 2 million rounds of dirty bombs a month. 5.5 million rounds a month for 9 years. To get 11,000 people. You're the worst shots on the planet. You're the most stupidest people on the planet. 5.5 million rounds should take out 10,000 people in a couple of fucking days. Not 9 years, and they're still out there bombing everything. 22,000 drone strikes, millions dead, millions missing for 11,000 fucking people. And you're supposed to be a great warriors, the great army. Shut the fuck up, boy. You're morons. You're the stupidest people on the planet. You're the stupidest in history. And in history, if there is one, we'll look back and said, these are fucking morons. 5 million orphans to get 11,000 people. How can you justify that? Right now in Syria, you got 9 million in refugee camps because of 10,000 ISIS. Are you people mentally fucking ill? You created 9 million refugees. Because of 10,000 people. And you argue about it and fight about it every fucking day. How the ISIS is going to chop someone's head off. With 9 million people without a home. Because you're too fucking stupid to shut up and say, hey, who cares? It's only 10,000. And they're created and funded by the CIA to fucking throw down Syria and Libya. And fucking Iran's got 49 bases around it. 49 military bases around it, and they're the threat. I'm so pissed off with this fucking planet. And the nuclear industry in particular got me drove nuts. They got the whole planet fucking barbarized. Here's Norway. It's barbarized. Denmark, barbarized. UK, barbarized. From Sellafields, 4 million liters a day going into the fucking ocean. Oh, the whales are dying down there. Of course they're fucking dying down there. These elements are pure energy. They're putting out energy. There's your global warming. Stupid. Hello, stupid. That's global warming. It doesn't stop putting out energy every second. Forever. It's like a little fire that never goes out. Relights itself every second. That's not heat. That's not energy, Dana. No, that's just radiation, Dana. Yeah, but it can power a gram of it. Can power 333,000 watt heaters. Because a gram of it produces a million watts of energy for 18 fucking months. But it's got no energy, Dana. It was atomizing aerosol. That's why Gil Medi was feeding it to the puppies. And New Mexico at Loveless. And killing him with it. He showed you for 35 years the tiniest particle will kill you. And then you go down, you fire dirty bombs left over from the production of it in other people's countries. And you produce those little babies with no faces, no arms, no lips, no heads, no fucking nutting, no future. You wrecked your entire country, their pensions. Let me jump. Because otherwise I'll go right down the fucking road here tonight. Let me bring myself around. Let me become lucid again. Atmospheric science, trans-Pacific air pollution. Oh, well, what do you mean trans-Pacific air pollution? Those particles are fucking 10,000 times the size of the radiation from Fukushima. But you mean to say the automobile pollution can make it over North America? Yeah, that's right. Wackoo boy. Oh, yes, man. But radiation? No, radiation can't make it over here, you fucking moron. Dana's a moron. The fucking radiation can't come over here. Yeah, but the pollution comes over. Yeah, but they're big fucking particles. The wind picks them up, Dana. The radiation is really heavy particles. They fall down to the ground, Dana. Are you that fucking stupid? And they are. Eurasian air pollution reaches eastern North America. Uh-huh, go figure. But those particles are way, way freaking bigger. Thousands of times bigger. Than an atom. They're particles. But they're bigger than an atom. And stuff coming out of Fukushima is an atom. Yeah. Ding, ding, ding. Does it register yet? How much they lie to you and manipulate you and deceive you? Oh, all the pollution come over. But not the radiation. Right. So if you put all the four reactors in that model and the 2,000 elements, man-made ionized elements, by the way, there's only about 260 normal, stupid background radiation that can't hurt a fucking, couldn't even mutate a fruit fly. All of these will mutate and kill that fruit fly and their larvae. I know, I just come out to yell tonight. That's all I've done. I know, I'm guilty. Guilty! Guilty of being a dick. Let's see if I can do something else with my fucking time here. What it is, I'm getting agitated. I want to go. I can't stand being home. I want to go out there and fucking get the job done so I can give it up. It's so much fucking work. It's got to get done. It's just a stupid amount of work. I won't stop work. It'll take me, even if I pull this off in the next 3 months, it'll still take me another 2 months to upload everything. I don't know what to fucking do. Gotta find out. You gotta prove definitively, I guess. Massive spikes! Attempts to stop the flow of radioactive liquids! Hang on, we'll do this one down here. U.S. nuclear workers' brains were eaten away, hallucinating, and they throw them away. Throw them away like they're homeless down in Fukushima. Working at Fukushima. Twice as much Fukushima radiation. Twice as much. Twice as much. See, whoever wrote that headline should be strangled. Not till they're dead, but let them come back to life like you would waterboard them and strangle them a fucking again. Because you have to be stupid to write that. The plumes are coming out of Fukushima nonstop. They only reported on a couple of days' releases from Unit 1. And the plumes, traveling at 5 miles an hour, will reach your coastline in 45 fucking days. Not only that, the aerosol, the disposition, the fallout from the aerosols, will wash back down to your coastline. That's where fucking water goes, stupid. That's Ken Buechler. The fucking idiot, man. That fucking little maggot. He came on board when it happened, and he hasn't shut up since, and he gets all the traction. He's up there everywhere. Every mainstream media puts Banana Boy up there, and all he talks about is bananas. Oh, it's like a banana. It's like potassium 40. You ever hear him, Weasel? Like, I've listened to a lot of his lectures. He's a friggin' weasel. He's the worst thing ever happened to this planet. We will never fucking forget you, Ken. TV barrier is not holding Fukushima plant, and all the efforts have failed to stop very high levels of radioactive material flowing into the ocean. Huh? Say what? Go away, boy. The barrier is not holding. What barrier? What the fuck are you talking about? What the fuck are these people talking about? Barrier. There is no barrier at Fukushima. The problem is, nobody will fucking tell the truth. And all E&E News is doing is linking you. That's a hot link. Look, open that link in a new tab. Come down, open that link. It's just a paragraph from each one. E&E News is not discredited. E&E News is not evil or bad or maniacal or sneaky or tricky or deceptive or deceitful. All they're doing is aggregating energy news. We wouldn't have any news to read if people didn't do it. Someone has to fucking do it. If it's not the New York Times, it must be fucking a troll site. Is that right? You know, these people need to be strangled or hung in the streets. There's no way around this. Just hang the fuckers, all of them. We need an evolution. And the evolution is we got to get rid of this revulsion of nuclear industry, nuclear apologists, and nuclear destructive. It's fucking going to kill the entire friggin' planet at the rate it's going. You people better smart up. That are in the media. You got to stop fucking doing that job. Just tell your boss, no, I'm not going to do it. Quit your fucking job. Grow up here. Come out and write a book. Oh, do you want me to lie about Fukushima? Be the most popular person on the planet. You quit your job and say, I wouldn't lie about Fukushima. I'm tired of lies. It's not like a banana. Ken Buechler is a fucking lawyer. Jay Collins is a lawyer. Tara Cascio from Alberta University is a liar. They are manipulating you and deceiving you and tricking you. Raymond Gilmedi, Dr. Raymond Gilmedi, killing all those beagles. What does that tell you? Do you think that's the only laboratory out there killing animals with radioactive elements all the time for the last 70 years? No. There's nothing on the planet that's acclimated to it. And so I don't know why people are demonizing E&E News. All they're doing is aggregating it and giving you a paragraph. Many animals on the sea floor looking dead or sick. And I've been telling you for how long that for the last couple of months that the sea urchins and the sea cucumbers and the whelks and the snails and everything are only about 1% to 1% and that most of the species are missing. Yet they're going to try to blame it on a pathogen. They're going to try to blame it on domoric acid. They're going to try to blame it on fictional fantasies and mysterious sicknesses and illnesses that they can't explain. But they won't bother mention the R word. They won't bother mention that Fukushima is hemorrhaging into the ocean from something we've never seen before on this planet, from four melted reactors. We've never seen 100% melted reactors. You people got to get back in their faces. You got to get in their faces. When they lie, you gotta let them know that you're not gonna put up with it anymore. That's what I do all the time. I'm not gonna take it anymore. I ain't gonna take it lying down. Urchins and sea cucumbers. Now, I talked to a couple of divers out there, and there was just a couple of sea cucumbers where they were diving. And we were there for like 2 hours. They were diving the whole time. And when they were boat on the boat, I went up to them and I asked them, you know, what was the sea cucumbers? Because I can't find any. And he said there was a couple there. I said, could you pick 1,000 pounds? And he laughed at me. He said, no, just a couple. Dear. And the significance of that is you should be able to pick 5, 10, 15,000 pounds of sea cucumbers no matter where you go. In the harbors, it doesn't matter where you go. Those things populate the entire coastline like rocks. They're like fucking rocks, only there's more of them. Sea cucumbers. They're filter feeders. They're all gone. There's some left, a tiny, tiny percentage. Kelp forest ecologist Like, all E&E News is just linking you over to those fucking people. How are these, people at E&E News putting up all trolls? Because all E&E News is putting up there is the mainstream apologists, but they're also funding the researchers, and they're just linking you over and giving you a paragraph. And they're telling you, now I didn't see anything look that healthy, but they're telling you, same thing I'm telling you and I'm showing you, at thenuclearproctologist.org. And I covered this one last night, didn't I? Some nights I crash and burn. Some nights I crash and scream. Some nights I just slow it all down and have a normal night. And what I'm trying to do is keep the momentum going. I don't want to lose the momentum. I'm terrified I'm going to lose the momentum. And I'm tired of the nonsense. I'm tired of the misdirection. And I'm tired of people coming to my site and pretending that what I'm saying is not factual. Because why would I say it if it's not factual? What have I got to gain by doing that? How easy would it be to take the stuff I'm saying and then use it to discredit me? Why would I fucking do that? And I'll swear if I want to. If you don't like it, go to fuck somewhere else. That's who I am. I'm not going to change who I am just to please you. I'm not going to sit up straight because you don't like me slouching. I'm not going to hold my chin up because you want my fucking chin up. I don't tell you how to live your life. Please don't tell me how to live my life. And I have so many people criticize me the way I dress, the way I talk. Don't talk with a fucking accent, Dana. Sit up straight, Dana. Chest out. Stomach in. Shoulders back. Don't show aggression, Dana. Ain't Dana word, Dana. Get a shave, Dana. Cut your hair, Dana. Why don't you wear a tie, Dana? Why don't you wear a jacket, Dana? The ocean is dying. I don't care, Dana. Wear a tie. I can't find any of the species on the coastline. Sit up straight, Dana. You know, what's your logic? Oh, you should. You didn't need to put a cabin on the boat. You could have went down in America and to the Florida. I'm not American. I'm a Canadian, and I got 26,000 islands up there on the most prestigious coastline imaginable. It was. America's coastline is fucking almost destroyed anyway. Over 300 million people, we got 30-odd million in Canada. And a lot of these islands, most of these islands, no one's ever walked on them, except for me and a few other people. I've walked on around 4,000 of these islands up here. I dove amongst these islands for many, many years, up to 315 days a year, year after year, living in those islands. I know exactly what I'm doing. That's why I'm doing it. Expert, seemingly benign virus, innocuous and harmless, on the West Coast is causing ecological upheaver, like the likes we've never seen by. Very peculiar, tell you what. Different from all other known viruses, but we don't know what it is. It's a benign one. Mutations could be helping it spread around. Oh, Jesus. So you can take any disease now in history and say, oh, it's probably that one, probably mutated. Yeah, that's what it is. No, it's not Fukushima radiation. Could be pollution, though, from Japan, but it's not radiation. Could be pollution from Asia, but it's not radiation. I mean, Jay Cullen from the University of Victoria, he's up on CBC for the last 3 years. Now he's saying there's melted reactors. But for the last 3 years, he said there, if there was a melted reactor, it'd be really different. I'd have to rethink everything we said. He knew right on day one when it was melted. And yet he's up there lying to you, lying to your loved ones, lying to your children, lying to your family and your parents and your aunts and your uncles and your friends and your neighbors and your country. And now he's going to go to all of our communities in British Columbia and lie to him and deceive him with just utter deception that he's a university professor. And therefore, whatever he say must be true. And he's going to use the globalist think tanks as sources instead of Dr. Raymond Gilmedi and the dead beagles. And he's going to equate it all with bananas and potato chips and walking in sunshine. And if he comes up against opposition, he'll mention dental x-rays and chest x-rays, and a chest x-ray, and a dental x-ray. You turn the fucker on, and then you turn it off. Then you go home. You get a particle in you, and you did. Up to 10 and 20 a day. Every day during March, April, May, June of 2011. And it takes 5-10 years for the cancers to show up. These cancers will show up in about 4 or 5 years after the accident, because they're hot particles. And now they're showed up. The entire coastline of Canada is almost eradicated. And it's Fukushima fallout. Completely annihilated the entire coastline. And we have the models, we have the dispositions. There really was 3 melted reactors at Fukushima. There really was. That really happened. Unit 1 really blew up and melted out, and its fuel pool inventory caught fire and atomized and aerosoled. And this is bad news. Real bad news. This is Unit 2. 100% meltdown. 100% meltthrow. 100% meltout. We've never seen it on the planet before, and our media are out there with their fucking pencils up their asses. Don't even know what their name is. They're drooling when they wake up in the morning, and they gotta get someone to wipe it off their face before they lie to you. These buildings, those pictures, are when the accident happened. What is the better picture for you? Would you rather see the picture of accident? You don't know nothing about it. Do I show you a picture of that? Right? Do I show you that picture? Or is it better that I come over and I show you? Gonna give me a hard time, all right? Dr. Raymond Gilmedy, mass murder and beagle killing monster. Oh, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy. I lost track of it. Hey, let me try it again. Hang on. I'm pretty good. You never know with me. I just not... I got too much shit on my computer. Sue me. I can't keep up with it. Don't even matter. So should I show you that building? Unit 4. I know what I'll do. If I can find it. Now where the shit did that go to? Don't click shit on your desktop, Dana. I give up. I was just on it. Yeah, it's supposed to be right there. Do I show you pictures of Unit 4? Let me find a good picture for you, though, first. Here's Unit 4. Does that building look like it's got a really intact... Like, there's the fuel pool right there, by the way. That caught fire, blew up, blew the walls off. This is a 10-story building. But they want you to think that inside of this building right here, inside of that, now they're not in there. That's why they're building that structure right there. Because they can't get into that fuel pool. That's the homeless getting their x-rays and neutrons and gammas, betas, alphas. And this is what they claim is what it looks like on the inside. And this is preposterous. The building is not symmetrical. Right? Where's that friggin' picture to? I just showed you. Uh-huh. So that building completely annihilated itself. And all they done was built a structure up across it. And eventually they're going to put a crane in that little house there. And they're going to try to reach in there. But at the same time, as that, they're showing you pictures of the interior saying it's like that. If it's like that, why would you need to build that structure? If it's like that on the inside, why would you build stuff like that? You don't need it. Obviously, you got everything under control. Look at it. Everybody's in there walking around. Life is good. These are TEPCO's official pictures. And the problem is, the media won't come out and talk about it. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 100% meltdown, melt through, melt out. And that's all I got tonight. I'm burnt out. 9:49. There's the fuel pool. I got rid of the other one. Hang on. If that's the fuel pool, how come they're not down in Chernobyl fixing that one up? Right, how can you have a destroyed building? You got a destroyed building, and but yet on the inside is perfect. Yeah? On the inside it's perfect. On the outside, it's destroyed. See, there's no logic in what you're looking at. And this is what they tell you. And media can't go and say, hey, no, look at this, guys. See, TEPCO's lying to you. Come on, TEPCO, smarten up. Stop lying to the people. We're here to protect our people. We're here to be journalists. We haven't got a fucking journalist out there we can turn to. Not one. Haven't got a single journalist on this planet we can fucking trust. Not one. Not a single one. And you got Tom Hartman over there. And what does he do? Global warming. He'll drag you in with Fukushima and nail it over and over and over and over and over. Global warming. You're a fucking dick for using tin cans, cardboard, and plastic. Global warming bastard. But that's what Tom Hartman does. He brings you in there. He gets someone up there. And he say the same fucking nonsense. And then he drag you into global warming. Here's the official pictures. These are both official pictures. You can download them under my video. There's a couple of thousand of them right from TEPCO's website. Hi, Sarah, Rihanna, Kitty, Annabek. Yeah, where I'm going. That was just you, Annabek. I'm winding down, folks. Let me give her a break. It was a good night. Same as last night. Sometimes I do shit like that for a couple of weeks at a time. I know I've been doing this for a year. Now, this Fukushima. But if someone lands on one of my videos, it's just like you watched all my videos. Right? You pretty well learned the same thing, but a little bit better, a little bit more positive. A few ha-ha-ha's. You chuckle, chuckle, chuckle. So transboundary pollutions influences on the aerosol concentration in the United States. What transboundary means is coming across the ocean from another country. But not radiation, right? You give your head a shake. When it falls off, give it a kick. Better yet, send it to me. We'll give it a good kick. We'll give it a good kick. And I'll be heading back out into the shit again, back out, and I'll be nice and dry, warm. I went out and put the beads all around, everything's enclosed on the boat now, I went out and put beads all around it. There's no water getting in that boat, I got the front all sealed up, there's no water going to come in through that. And we got the back is all sealed finally, and I deflated the pontoons on it today and got into the cabin and sealed. There's a cabin that anybody's not familiar. There's a cabin on the boat now. And this is what I'm going into. 26,000 islands. Once I get up to close to the islands, it'll be a lot better. I'll be able to hide away. And if it gets too rough, I'll just stay there overnight. I got a cabin. It's perfect. Spectacular, really. And it's necessary because you get fatigued doing that, right? Well, we'll be back again tomorrow night. Today's Sunday. Tomorrow night might be my last blog until I get back. And so tomorrow night will be a good blog. I won't do one of my tonight routine. It'll be a little bit different, hopefully. And so good night to everybody. Good night, Chuck. Good night, Lunar. Good night, Miss Milky and Bob and Manderson and Cotton Top. And we'll see you folks tomorrow night. Just gotta make sure. Take care, folks.